Hello, I'm Joel Young. Most of you already know me. I'm a living wisdom presenter from way back, and I'd really like to be with you there today. However, I'd also really like to be surfing in Taranaki with my best friends, so I have done that instead. Because it meets a deep need in my life, really. A deep need for fun, deep need for ease and community with some people that I really, really like. So that's where I am. However, I also have some needs to contribute to life and need to be effective and a need for community with you guys and a need for, I think, maybe progress. So what I've got today is a little video treat for you outlining some of the developments I've had of my therapy and my thoughts around what is helpful for people. So I want to talk to you about needs. So to warm up a little bit to this idea of needs, because while it's in the Living Wisdom Manual and it's talked about in a few different places, it's probably a little bit unfamiliar for you to really focus in on them. So stop for a second, go inside yourself and listen to your body and your feelings and think, what am I feeling right now? What am I feeling and what am I needing? And hit pause on the video just to consider that for a moment. Unpause. Welcome back. Well, why am I talking about needs anyway? Well, I'll tell you why, very briefly though. It's because some really important people that I respect a lot think needs are important. So, for starters, we've got this guy, David Riddell. I believe some of you know him. And he talks about it. We can see in here, he talks about needs. That we've got some fundamental emotional needs. You see that there in the small type? For things like significance, safety, progress, and innocence. Makes sense to me. What I've also noticed is that some other guys say some stuff. Larry Crabb talks about our understanding people in a book title, Deep Longings for Relationship. God said something about it's not good for man to be alone, which maybe might mean something about how we've got these really strong emotional needs for connection with people, community, that kind of stuff. And then this guy Marshall Rosenberg, who's really made the lights go on for me, whoosh, like that, about needs. And he's got the statement that's rather bold, that says everything that we do is in service of our needs. Everything. Would you believe that? Not sure if I did. So I've been thinking about it. One thing I think that we tend to do with our needs is we tend to shame them. We even have sayings in society like, oh, they're so needy. I'm sure you've heard someone say that. But I don't think it's very useful to shame our needs. What are our chances going to be of meeting our deep emotional needs if we shame on them? We're not going to be meeting them, we're going to be busy trying to hide them. So what I think would be great is if we actually start to realize that they're just part of us, it's part of what it means to be human, is to have needs. And then we might set about finding some decent strategies to meet these needs, whether it's thinking a different way or doing things a different way. So I've got a couple questions for you. The first one is, what is a need that you have that you don't let yourself have? And my second question, who told you that it wasn't okay to have that need? Big questions. Have a think. Might find it useful. When I talk about needs, I'm not talking about strategies. I think a lot of the time we get these things mixed up and we think that a need is something like money or a car or something like that. While money's great and cars are really helpful, they're really just strategies that help us fulfill our needs. So a car might help me get around to a mate's place, which will help fulfill my need for mutuality or company or fun even. And money, while that's great, it's not really the need. It might be more about having a sense of security or a sense of choice or freedom. So needs are quite different. I think we tend to get mixed up when we talk about feelings. Some of the things we call feelings, I don't think are actually feelings. And what you'll notice in this little graph I've got behind me is that some of the things we think are feelings are actually faux feelings or thoughts, really. And if we look at them as thoughts, we can get a lot more power over them. So have a look at this little graph I've got here. I find it quite helpful. Abandoned, you might think abandoned's a feeling, right? I used to call it a feeling. But the feeling here really is something like terrified or hurt, bewildered, sad, frightened, and lonely. And maybe this person's needing some nurture, some connection, some belonging, some support. That's quite different. The problem with just staying with the faux feeling that's abandoned is it's not nearly as clear. And what I've found is that a lot of people really lack clarity, and that's why they come to counselling or something like that, is to get some clarity. I've noticed that being able to reflect to someone what their true feelings are, aside from their evaluations, and their true needs are, aside from their strategies, can result in some rather life-changing empathy. So what I've done is put together a resource, some cards. These aren't poker cards, although you can use them to play empathy poker. Cheesy, but true. Because sometimes, when you're feeling a bit vulnerable, it's really nice someone can reflect to you your feelings and needs and help you get a bit of clarity.